Guess what, guys? I'm alive. So, I'm feeling pretty great. The surgery took, as expected, about 2 hours, and there were no complications. It all went well. So I think I'm down one adrenal gland. I've had a couple of hiccups afterwards, but I'm good. So afterwards I looked down, I lifted up my shirt, and there was blood everywhere. That was about an hour or two after, actually 2 or 3 hours after the surgery, so that wasn't supposed to happen. But yeah, it did get a bit messy after that, trying to stop the bleeding, and I my blood pressure dropped really quickly. I started feeling really out of it. But once the bleeding was sorted, I came right, so that was good. And I haven't had a bleed since, and that was yesterday, so that's fine now. My first walk to the toilet was eventful. I got really excited because I got up. Well, I need a couple of people to help me get to the toilet and go toilet, and that actually went better than I expected. So I got a little bit excited and thought, you know what, I'm going to wash my face and I'm going to put some moisturizer on to freshen up. And once I washed my face, all of a sudden, snap, I felt like I was, I started passing out. I felt like I was going to throw up, and so we got me back to the bed, and I lost all my hearing, and started going down. Once we got my oxygen back in, and sat me down, laid me back down, and got me back into the position that I've been staying in, then eventually I felt better. So and I've gone for a few hours later, I went for another walk to the toilet, and I was fine that time around. Pain increases, getting quite dizzy and sick, but nothing compared to the first time. Sorry, cut out there. So my lovely husband, poor thing, he didn't get home, well, he didn't leave until around 3 a.m. So he was here for emotional support for me. I just, you know, wanted him around. Poor thing was just so tired and hungry, so he eventually got to escape, go home with my boy, my baby. So Levi has been with one of my best friends, and sorry, the nurses keep coming in and out and just checking up on me and changing fluids and stuff. You can actually see me now because we've opened the curtains. It's morning, so I think we're 11 hours post-op now. So what I was saying is Levi has been with a very close friend of mine, and they absolutely love each other. She's been around since he was a baby. So they've had a blast. I got to call him last night, so I absolutely, like, completely lost my voice for quite a few hours there, but once I started picking it back up and I didn't seem so scary, then I got to FaceTime him and have a chat with him, which was really cool. He's been spoiled. He went to the park and caught up with some friends, and then he had a couple of movies with his auntie, my friend, and she stayed over with him. yeah, I'm really excited to see him today. He was a bit nervous about what I was going to be like when he came in to see me. He's quite scared. So I said, what would make you feel better about coming to see me? And he said, if you dressed up as a turtle, which was such an 8-year-old thing to say. Unfortunately, I don't actually have a turtle outfit. And we had a brainstorm about what we would do there, but it didn't really end up happening. And I think he's going to be okay. But he loves teddies. So I said to him, I'll take one of your teddies, and then you'll know, and I'll keep it with me, and you'll know that your teddy's taking care of me. And then when you come in, you'll see your teddy, and you'll know that everything's okay. So there's his teddy down the bottom there, and that's Patty, because Patty looks like a paddle pop, so that's why she's called Patty. And the lovely nurses here gave me another teddy for him, which we named over the phone Brookie Bear. It's a Brooke, my friend Brooke is a nurse, and it's got a stereoscope, so and that's what they're called. So yeah, that's he's got these teddies to come into, and also a colouring book they've given me for him, so that'll keep him busy, because he gets a bit agitated when he's in, when he comes to visit me in hospital. So that'll keep him busy. You'll enjoy that. So I had I managed to get a 2-hour sleep in, which was lovely, and I feel so much better after that. So I was a normal person tired. I haven't felt that for a long time, so I wasn't fatigued. I actually felt like I needed to go to sleep, which was really nice. It's funny, really nice to feel normal person tired. But yeah, I can't sleep on my back, so I managed to actually get on my side and have a little nap, so that was good. And wasn't waking up from pain, which was nice. But when I did wake up, I was like, yeah, I'm ready to stay up for a little bit. I was expecting, I was told I was only going to be allowed ice for the first day, and then sips of water for the second, and then and probably third. And after the third, that we would try to give me like a smoothie. But I've tolerated really well, so I started drinking water pretty much straight away without feeling sick, and I've had 2 ice blocks, and my tummy is making noises, which if it starts to make noises, that's a good sign. So I actually just waiting to see the surgeon, but apparently it's pretty likely that I will get onto food today, which, you know, I'm really excited about. Yeah, and if I'm eating and if I'm not bleeding anymore and everything is looking good, then I might even be let out after a couple of days rather than we're expecting 3 days, so maybe 2 days. So that's a really good sign. So I think I'm recovering pretty well. Yeah, it's a lovely day outside. So I hope you're all out there enjoying that. I mean, some of you will be watching from somewhere else where it's not lovely, but anyway, yeah, I'm definitely enjoying it with the curtain open, and once I can get up and go for a walk, which isn't really urgent, then I'll definitely get up and get some fresh air. Yeah, I think that might be my update for now, and yeah, just positive vibes here. I guess the medication helps. Okay, bye.